What is going on, everybody? Arlie's here, back on the video here today, and we are going to be watching The Summer I Turned Pretty Season 2, Episode 7. Last episode was wild, really crazy, really amazing in so many ways. Taylor and Steven, the kiss, the moment, the fight between her, Milo and Steven was a funny, hilarious, and the stupid. I loved the Belly Conrad talk. That was really, really good for them to finally have that conversation, but then it got interrupted by Jeremiah, so that sucked. Belly breaking down, calling her mom in the end, man. Like, I can't wait to see what happens with that. I don't know, man. I'm just excited. Honestly, I'm really, really excited to see what else is going to happen in this season. I think it's going to be crazy. I don't like the odds for Conrad, man, getting Belly back, man. I really don't right now, because it doesn't look like she's too interested. Looks like she's just moved on to Jeremiah. And I'm nervous for that, but we'll see. I love the Sky and Cam moment. I love the friendship that they're building, the bond, the relationship, you know, all that. It seems good. So I'm excited to see what else is going to happen with that. I love her encouraging him to get on the boat and all that stuff. So it's going to be interesting. But I'm excited to see what else happens in this season and in this episode, next episode. Let's get right into it. Thank you guys for all the support on it. I am like 10 subscribers away from 600. So if you guys can please just like the video, comment, subscribe. It means so much. All these episodes will be available on Patreon. And it's Mirabar Lizzy. Let's get right to the episode. Here we go.
Mom? What are you doing here?
You don't remember? You asked me to come. No, actually, you left me a message begging me to come.
Yeah.
And then you didn't answer when I called back. You've been lying to me for days.
Hey, yikes.
Jeremiah and Conrad, they needed my help, and I didn't know how to tell you.
There is no excuse. None. I really hope last night was worth it, because I am so done with you.
Mom, we didn't come here to party. It just happened. We came here for Susanna.
Stop it! I can't stand to hear you use her as an excuse one more time.
You can't stand me, period. Dang. Ever since her funeral, you have been so angry with me.
What do you want me to say? That you embarrassed me? That you made that thing all about you when it was supposed to be about Susanna?
Yes,
that's true.
I know you hate me for it, okay? But you will never hate me as much as I hate myself.
Come on. We are not doing this here. Let's go.
Susanna would never forgive you for abandoning her boys.
Ooh.
She would never even believe.
Ooh. Oh my God. I saw that coming.
Belly.
Dang. Oh, she stopped and looked at Conrad. Oh.
I knew that you and Conrad had talked in the fall about me.
Really? What the?
But I had no idea that he came to you begging for your blessing.
Actually.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. I keep trying to make everything right, and I just keep fucking it up. He's just only trying to, you know,
don't
fix.
Don't defend him to me. Just this once, please.
Well, you're the one in the wrong. He never said anything that bad about you.
There is nothing left between me and Conrad.
That's cap. Cap.
There'll always be something between you and Conrad.
There will be. Yep.
What the hell?
Mom.
Belly drunk dials me and I drive all night to find this? I'm just glad your mom isn't here to see what you guys did to her house. I want this place spotless. And for every single thing of Susanna's to be put back exactly where it belongs. If even one thing is broken or missing, I swear to God.
Mom, we weren't the ones who moved
the house.
Stuff.
Is empty.
It was Aunt Julia. She's the one who emptied it, not us. To sell it.
But I thought Susanna talked to her lawyers. She told me she reached out to Julia right before things got bad.
Wait, then why didn't you say anything? Conrad had to find out from a for sale sign in the front yard.
I just assumed they resolved it before Susanna. Connie, does your dad know?
Of course he knows. And of course, he's done nothing at all to help us.
Yeah, that's why the guys and Belly came here. They were trying to work something out with Aunt Julia themselves.
And?
And we failed. Aunt Julia's already sold the house to another family. They finalized the deal yesterday. But like you said, at least my mom's not here to see it.
I know I fucked up. All right, and Belly too, but at least she was here. The second they needed her, she stepped up. You didn't even tell anyone this was coming.
Yeah.
Stephen, I've been trying to...
Try harder then.
Big facts, Stephen.
You were right. I have been angry. I've been so fucking angry at how unfair it is that Beck's not here anymore. I should have been there for you. Or let somebody be there for me. Yes. Do you forgive me?
I'm glad they made up really quickly. Really quickly. Because it was bad that she slapped her. That was really bad.
It just doesn't feel the same without
her. Look at these two.
What?
I owe you all an apology. You guys have been there for each other, and I haven't. And I'm deeply sorry for that.
We've all made mistakes, Mom.
Well, my biggest one is trusting that Beck and Julia had come to an agreement about the beach house before she passed. It's probably too late to change things, but I'd like to try.
Hey, love to hear it. Love to hear it.
Change her mind.
Thank you, Mom. Thank you.
I don't want you to leave. Like, you know that, right? We're clear on that.
Crystal, babe. Yeah.
Well, oh, babe.
I want you to stay too.
Oh.
And I adore you for it. I think it's better if I leave. I think this is feeling more and more like a family thing.
You sure you're not just trying to get out?
Do you want to drive a girl to the bus station?
Oh.
Bus station? What? No. Look, if you're going to go, use my car.
Oh.
I'm going to get the
car. They're cute, man. They're amazing.
Okay, so I clearly missed.
Ooh.
Bye.
Be safe. Okay. Remember to fill the tank with gas when it's half empty. It's like road trip 101.
But it'll still be half full then. Regular unleaded, right?
But that's a joke. For high octane premium, the good stuff.
Wow. Jeez.
Julia. I know you and Beck had your issues,
correct?
And that the kids have made an already difficult situation for you even harder.
Also correct.
But the fact is, Susanna loved this house, and the boys desperately miss their mother, and those two things are pretty tangled up in one another. I'm hoping you'd consider backing out of the sale. I know she wanted to talk to you before.
If Susanna really wanted to talk to me, she would have called. Instead, she sent a letter.
Damn.
About the trust. That's where I found out that her cancer had come back and that she wasn't going to make it.
There wasn't a lot of time.
She could have called.
It's not a conversation she wanted to have. With anyone.
In the letter, she said she trusted I'd do the right thing and keep the beach house and the family.
Wow. And she just sold it?
How could she possibly expect that when this family's never done right by me? I tried to tell Susanna about it, but she didn't want to accept it.
Beck never liked to dig into the messy.
Our little Daisy Buchanan.
But you have to know how much she loved you.
Oh, come on, Laurel. There was no room for me in Susanna's life. And not a literal free room in this house. Not with you and your family here for months at a time. It was your place, wasn't it? Yours and Susanna's and the kids. You belong to it.
But
isn't that what you said?
in your memoir?
When I said Beck and I were like sisters, I wasn't trying to imply that she didn't already have one. And I never meant to make you feel unwelcome in your own house. I don't think Beck did either.
That's not on
they
you.
They could make it those two.
And to be perfectly fucking honest, it's not on Susanna either.
They could make it their house now, you know?
It's just, being here in this house and just stirred up a lot of shit I thought I'd gotten over. I never wrote her back. I never said goodbye.
Damn.
I tried to get on the plane for the funeral, but I had a ticket, but just couldn't do it.
Wow.
God, I wish I'd tried harder to fix things with her. It's not too late.
That's a lot of pain, man. That's a lot. I can't imagine that.
I've decided to pull out.
Let's go.
Yes.
What?
Let's not celebrate yet. We still need to convince your dad to buy the house from Julia.
Can we talk about last night?
Honestly, last night was kind of a blur. Whatever I said.
You're right.
No.
I never should have ended things like that. And the fucked up thing is I thought I was doing the right thing by you.
You were going through a lot.
But that is no excuse. And I hate the thought of you looking back on the night that we spent here together and regretting what we did.
Dang.
Of course it hurts to think about that night. But I don't regret it. I don't regret any of the times we were together. I loved you.
Bro, not the loved. Not the loved.
And I know you loved me too.
If I could go back, if I could do things differently, I would.
Conrad, it's okay. I mean, we both hurt each other a lot.
And I don't ever want to hurt you.
Oh, bro, this is amazing, bro. This is. Just tell her you love her or something. No. Bro, tell her, man. Bro, I'm annoyed.
I'm proud of you. You felt how you felt. Without apology. You even risked my wrath. But don't make a habit of disagreeing with me. I won't stand for it.
Well, don't do things that make me disagree with you. It's weird.
It's been a weird week.
A fun one, though. Wait.
Oh, guys.
Well, there was dancing.
Uh-huh.
And I made an apple bong. And, I had my first kiss.
Really?
Whatever.
See, it's good to see Julie like this.
I can't kiss him.
It's good to see her like this, actual person.
Well, he's super nerdy, and he loves whales.
Whales?
Julia sold it.
She didn't.
Actually, I am. Changed my mind. Hi.
Okay, well, let's get something straight here. I'm not letting them lose anything. This has been out of my hands since the start, so don't go making me the bad guy here.
Bro.
I'm not making you out to be anything. I'm trying to help you.
Let someone else try to solve a problem for once. So what, you're just going to dissolve the trust and gift the boys the beach house?
No, she can't do that. She has a child of her own to consider.
Yeah, well, I'm not going to squander their trust to buy this house, and frankly, I'm surprised that you would support that.
When did I ever say that? I just want you to move some money around to buy it for them.
What?
Fair market value. Terms negotiable, of course.
I think I'm going to go now because that's...
Bro.
That's not happening. End of story.
You know what? I have a question for you. Why is it that those boys have been trying harder for the last 3 days to save this house than you have in the last several weeks?
Adam.
No, shut up, Laurel. You don't have a vote, okay?
Dang.
I know Sue's made you feel like this house is part yours, but it's not.
Where do you get off saying shit like that?
Can't...
Ooh.
It's for the best. Did you really think railroading me would change my mind?
Excuse me, but fuck you.
Okay, all right, all right.
Suze wouldn't want us fighting like this.
You have no idea what she would want. You lost her a long time ago.
Can't you get past your own grief and see what it means to the boys?
Look, I thought it would be better this way. Easier for everyone if we let this place go.
Wow. Easier for you?
Yeah. Being here is hard.
I wanted to be in Conrad's name. Conrad and Jeremiah's name. Like, I wanted to be for them, like their house, them to own it.
Look, I'm not gonna let them use their trust. But if I sell the Boston house, that could give us enough. You'd both be at school mostly anyway, but we can't afford both houses. This is really what you want?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Dang. We never saw their Boston house, did we? Not really.
But I'm being serious. I don't want to keep fighting with you. We can't keep going like this. We're all we have.
All right, so we talk. Now, if something comes to mind, we say it, and whether it hurts or pisses each other off,
we talk.
We got into Stanford.
What?
Yeah, I planned to transfer a while back with Mom. And I don't want to tell you. I didn't want to tell you because I didn't want you to think I was deserting you or something. But look, I'm not going to go. I'm going to stay proud. Not going.
I don't know, man. I feel like his mom would want him to go to Stanford.
To both of you, I'm sorry. I know I haven't been the best dad and best husband to your mom.
Well, thank you for helping me save Mom's house. All right, Ed. I'll probably pull my acceptance for missing my final tomorrow.
Cool. Then you won't miss it.
Jared. There's no way I would pass it. Esquire's exams are nearly impossible when I'm up to speed, let alone now.
Then it's possible. Come on, we'll pull an all-night study session and we'll get you ready for it.
It's no problem.
You got this.
Don't look at me like that.
Look at you like what?
Well, I may not have much to compare the kiss to as of yet, but consider me Team Cam Cameron.
Bro.
The kids have gotten close.
Yeah, this guy's really blossomed here.
I'm sure the boys would love if you both visit often. You wouldn't have to worry about me. I'd steer clear.
Oh, no, no, no. I need your help keeping them in line. They're so impossible. Stubborn.
I would love to see this. You know, her kind of step into all Susanna's role. It would be good. It'd be really
not
good.
Getting rid of me forever.
Actually, I was wondering, could you stay for like one more night? Mm-hmm. Come on, we have to help Khan study for his final. It's tomorrow.
Dude, you know I'm 18, right? Like, I don't need my mom's permission to... I need my mom's permission to study.
Well, please. They're not going to let me transfer to Stanford if I don't pass this.
You better do more than just pass.
Yes, ma'am.
You really got in?
Oh, she shook.
Yeah.
She shook.
You're going to have to sleep on a sleeping bag tonight.
Oh, we've got the motel room for one more night. You want it?
Oh, heck yes. Perfect.
Thanks.
They got that look. They still got that look, man. It's not something you can ever.
This will be the last thing I do for Conrad Fisher.
We'll not have.
Get him to Stanford. Once he's there, maybe we can finally let each other go.
Rise and shine.
Oh, wow.
Jack, you sleep through a tidal wave.
Good morning, Belle.
Morning. It's almost 5. I let you sleep for an extra half hour, so you better be grateful.
I'm grateful.
Wow.
All right.
You could eat cheeseburgers?
No. These are a crucial part of the reward system.
Why does he get to have one?
All right, okay. This is how it's going to work. Conrad studies. He gets a burger.
What about me?
Conrad studies. You get a burger.
It's a reward system, huh? What else do I get?
Look at this. Look at these looks.
Just the cheeseburgers. All right, let's get to it. So, let's see. I have a practice test.
Thank you. Seriously. Thank you.
I want to sleep good at night. I want a temple that's right. Can I get a man?
Okay, this one's not too bad. All right, where is the Golgi apparatus located?
Right near the nucleus.
That's correct. Bravo. Ready?
Oh, yeah. Oh.
Good job, everyone.
Woo!
Oh. 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 Oh.
I'm not gonna do it.
Oh. Yeah! Woo!
Bro.
I never would have pictured this. It's different than if Susanna was still here. But I think she'd approve. This feels pretty magical to me.
Please tell her you love her, Conrad. Please. This is your biggest moment, the best moment you got.
Venus is still an evening star. Gives me some kind of hope or something.
Yeah, I think you should feel optimistic.
It's just hard knowing how much I fucked up. What if they kicked me out of Brown and I don't, you know, they don't want me at Stanford? And...
then you'll figure it out.
Yeah.
And if you're lucky enough to get another chance, you'll do everything you can not to fuck it up again.
Dang. Who are you talking about, Conrad or Jeremiah? Please, he's talking about Conrad.
Conrad, I need to tell you something.
Need to what?
I've been having feelings.
Oh, shoot. Oh my god, bro. She was about to tell him he has feelings. She has feelings for Jeremiah, bro. Oh man, bro. This is annoying, bro. She wasn't gonna say about Conrad.
If you take forever to finish that book, you're gonna be destitute and I'll be long gone.
Man, I can't believe it. That's so sad, bro. I can't believe it, man.
I am gonna be so pissed. Wherever I am.
I hate you so much sometimes.
I love you too. Summer's end.
Damn, man, I can't imagine that pain, bro. She has to be in so much pain all the time. Yeah, Steven grew up a lot this season, man, a lot. And he might be my favorite character this season, honestly.
Don't know if I should.
Yeah, I don't know why he didn't. It's so late now.
Look, a couple days ago,
I would have begged you to stay with me. All right, and I would have probably threatened physical violence if you ever hurt her again. That doesn't mean I'd actually
do it. Always
do it.
I
want to put the thought out there.
I deserve it.
Yeah, no shit. But today, I just can't wait to go home and see Taylor again. That's all to say that people change. If you love her, man, tell her how you feel.
Yeah, I'm nervous though for if he tells her how he feels. I'm nervous for that. Yeah, that's what I thought. Right before they leave, though, I don't know. Bro, Jeremiah is so jealous and so petty. I don't understand. He's so heated.
Buddy?
She's a good girl.
That's my song. John Mayer, bro.
Loves her mama, loves Jesus, and America too, yeah. She's a good girl. Crazy about Elvis, loves horses. And a boyfriend too.
That's a song, bro. John Mayer, bro, has some bangers.
I'm never gonna be this super genius like Steven. But I just feel like volleyball was something I was really good at.
You are really good at. And if you really wanted to, you could play here.
Yeah, true. I mean, wait, she goes there? She'd be only 15 minutes away from Conrad, you know, yo. We might have to, you know.
I'm going to ask my coach if there's any way that I can get back on the team when I get home.
Oh, actually, she's not, because Conrad's going to Stanford, so dang. Yeah, she's so into him, man. She's so into him. She's not really thinking about Conrad, man. It sucks, man. It's tragic.
Are you ever going to give me a second chance?
Oh, man.
Belly, if I fall for you again, I don't think I can take it if you change your mind like last time.
I wouldn't do that. It's different now.
How?
You and I mean, we're not the same people we were. We grew up.
Bro, you only been a year older, bro.
And now I want something real.
Bro. Bro.
What? I want you.
Bro. Belly.
Bro, this really isn't Conrad's season, bro. This really is not his season, man. I can't believe it, bro. Bro, imagine Conrad sees this, bro. They doing this right. Are they back in his school? Bro, this is this, bro. This is killing my whole vibe, bro. I really hope they're not at Conrad's school, bro. Because I don't want him to see this, man. This is tragic. Damn, man. Damn. Wow, what an ending. I feel bad for Conrad. He deserves better. I don't care what anybody says. He deserves better. That kiss was trash. I do not support. I don't know. I guess they're going to be together now. So I'm interested to see how the season ends, how it wraps up. I'm not sure if they have the same amount as last season, but they have to, right? Because this was episode 7. They had 7 last season, I believe. This season has to have at least one more or something, right? I can't imagine. I mean, that could be the season finale, though. That could be. That would not be a horrible one. But I'm excited, though. That was did not end the way I wanted it to. Hopefully, Conrad passes final. Hopefully, he gets into Stanford. Yeah, I can't believe that they just kissed right like that, right in front of his school like that, bro. He's seen. Tragic, but I like the way everything happened. They own the house back. It's theirs. Laurel came through. Their dad came through. Julie came through. Everybody came through. I loved it. It was amazing. Yeah, man, this was a really, really good episode. I really, really liked it. Can't wait to see what happens next. I'm really interested to see what Conrad's journey is, though. I really, really want to see him just win for the rest of this season and next season. I just want to see him thrive, honestly. When he's happy and when he's not dealing with the weight of losing his mom and he's just removed from that, like a few years removed from that. I want to see how he is because I know he's amazing and really good when he's not just in a depressive, just down mood. And all that, but that's gonna wrap the video though. Hopefully y'all enjoyed it. If you did, please leave a like, comment down below, subscribe. It's been Royal Easy, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.